After Yusuf's tutorial video on how to connect the Xbox One controller to the PC, we started getting a lot of requests to do the same for a PS4 controller. Well, I have a PS4 controller here, so let's get it hooked up. My newest console is actually the PlayStation 2. I primarily game on PC with a keyboard and a mouse. However, certain games just play better with a controller, like racing games, third-person games, platformers, and especially if you're using an emulator. Now I have access to a PS4 controller, and I wanted to try it on the PC like I used to do with my PS3 controller. And the first thing that you're going to need is actually a micro USB cable. This is used to connect and charge your PS4 controller. And next, you'll need to download the DS4 Windows tool, which I'll have linked below. DS4 Windows is a tool that's maintained by users on the PS2 emulator PCSX2 forums. And the tool essentially takes the PS4 controller and then emulates it as an Xbox 360 controller. The software does give you several options, including the ability to set up macro keys, utilize the light bar, and even turns your touchpad into a touchpad mouse for your PC. Now, I do want to give you two heads-ups for the installer. I had to reshoot the video twice because the installer force restarted my computer, so make sure you don't have anything important open. And the other thing is that if you have less than 4 GB of space left on your machine, this installer may not work. This is due to how awful Microsoft's installer is for .NET. 4.5.2 would not let me pick the install directory, which takes up over 3 GB of space. I'm working on a home theater PC, which only has 40 gigs of solid-state drive, so this became an issue for me. If you're in this situation, the solution I had was to uninstall the previous .NET installation, which was nearly 3 GB as well. All right, the first page I have linked below is to the DS4 Windows forums. And as you can see from the date on here, the program was just updated yesterday. The guy who's maintaining this is constantly updating the program. So if you follow the download link on this page, it'll take you here, which shows you some of the features and what's new with the latest version. So go ahead and download the file. I'd suggest saving it to a folder where you can easily find it, like the desktop. And I already have mine saved, so we'll go ahead and walk you through the installation. All right, installing DS4 Windows is very straightforward. Just follow the prompts that are on the screen and be prepared for the computer to restart. I already have the prerequisites installed, so that screen won't show up on my end. But once all the prerequisites are installed, you can complete the installation on the DS4 tool, which does actually let you choose the install directory. So go ahead and follow this. Now, once the installer finishes, go ahead and connect your controller, and then launch the DS4 Windows tool. And once the DS4 Windows tool comes up and recognizes the controller, it should show your current charge rate, which is, in this case, fully charged. And I'll show you a couple of the options that are on here. The one thing they let you do is set profiles. You can create them or download them from the internet. And these are basically profiles for individual games or emulators. There's a log screen, which shows you log information. There's a settings option on here that allows you to change some settings for the program here and the controller. Theme option for the program, and something that looks like they're going to add in later on. There's a donation screen here. There's one person working on this project right now. So if you feel like donating to the project, you know, you can do so right here. And that's pretty much it. So I'm going to go ahead and launch Steam in big picture mode so you can see the controller in action. All right, and I'm using the controller right now. I'm going to go ahead and sign in my profile. Now, all the functions on this controller work just the same as if you had plugged in a wired 360 controller to your PC. So the bumpers control the bumper functions. The triggers perform the trigger functions. And instead of pressing the Xbox button, you'll actually be pressing the PlayStation button on here. The touchpad does work. The pushing down on the touchpad does not do left click. It's actually the right click option. But if you tap, that is the select function. So that's pretty much it. If you have any questions, feel free to comment below or post on our forums. All of the download links as well as a walkthrough that I wrote up are linked in the video description below. If this video helped you out, we post tons of other tech tutorials and reviews, so hit that subscribe button. And as always, thanks for watching.